This video will give you a basic overview of the logistics of shipping pipe by rail. Each day starts with a documented toolbox meeting. These toolbox meetings are to ensure the safety of our employees. Safety concerns, hazards, and best practices are discussed. Then, we complete a pre-job safety checklist. Pre-job safety checklists are used to ensure all the appropriate tools and equipment are accessible and in working condition, all required PPE is available, and that all job hazards are addressed. When used, we inspect the rigging equipment and straps and remove defective equipment from service. We inspect tag lines and make sure they're the right length, and also make sure there are no knots or defects. And we ensure the barricade radius is set up for the swing radius of the equipment. The barricade radius is identified by signs and proper roped-off areas. Standard personal protective equipment, or PPE, is required. This consists of an orange vest, fall protection gear, hard hats, steel-toe footwear, and safety glasses. Additional PPE requirements will be noted on pre-job safety checklists. The rail shipping process begins with notification of shipping pipe. This ensures that the proper pipe is being loaded. Next is the inspection of the rail car. We ensure that the rail car is properly positioned with the platform, and we ensure that no one is on either side of the rail car during loading. Also, people working at the ends of the rail car must be clear from the overhead load. Next, we inspect the pipe, looking for any damage. If found, the area foreman is notified so the damage can be properly documented and corrected. We also make sure that there is a minimum of 3 rope ring separators, and replace them as needed. With rail shipping, a signalman is required. His responsibilities are to ensure that personnel are safe and clear from overhead loads. He is positioned at the highest possible point, and he uses an established code of hand signals to authorize the equipment operator to move the pipes from the ground to the rail car. The equipment operator then moves the pipe from the rack to the rail car. Once the rail car is completely loaded and secured, it moves on to the strapping station, where pipe is secured and strapped onto the rail car. Here are a few final notes regarding the logistics of shipping pipe by rail. Make sure and keep the work areas clean, and ensure that proper housekeeping is maintained throughout the day to keep a clean, safe work environment. We require a cleanup at the end of each shift, and we make sure that no trash ever hits the ground. This concludes our training on the logistics of shipping pipe by rail. If you have any other questions, please make sure and ask the yard manager or area foreman.